Hi everyone, this is T. This is episode 35 of the AIDS End AIDS series that I started on December 1st last year. January 4th, 2022 today. And topic for today is, it's going to be a campaign to get Southern Time Productions funded. For reasons beyond just the viability of the potential bottom line and social impact that Southern Time Productions and Southern Time Foundation have, it's running out, right? Our goal was to end AIDS. UNAIDS' goal is to end AIDS by 2030. But the way things are going now, COVID-19 was a real setback for that, because it's taking all the resources and the attention from the other diseases that and issues, health, social, and environmental issues that are impacting our world. Humanity's got a singular focus these days, and we can't forget the other things. Other things are still there, right? And but that's a discussion for another day. Reasons for that will become apparent in time. But Southern Time Productions, the viability of project, because, I'm not getting any younger, it's like I'm still pretty good looking for my age, I guess, what's that actor's name? George Clooney, right? He was a middle age. He was around my age when he became famous. And so maybe that will work for me too. That's fine. But it's more than that. It's the viability. The project's ready to go. We just need funding to start hiring people so we can start working to make this happen, right? And but just the state of our world, yeah, those two things are, you can't say anything about what's going on these days, whether it's real virus induced pandemic or if it's something else, right? Something's really unstable about our world these days, and the stakes are high, right? Humanity could go into this transhumanist agenda, keep following this transhumanist agenda, where we merge the biology with technology, digital lives, right? Which we already are. Everyone's addicted to their smartphones. Right. So, but this is like, Elon Musk talking about putting something in your brain that could connect to the internet, right? Has read and write capabilities. That's science fiction stuff, but it's, they get the technologies here. It's been here for decades, actually. So it's being released now slowly, or increasingly more quickly now, actually. So that's, that's when the World Economic Forum says, by 2030, they said this last year, I think, they had it up and got so many dislikes, they took it down like a day or two later. And it was like, you'll own nothing and you'll be happy. It's like, oh, really? Why is that? I don't have anything in my heritage, like to give, pass on to my kids or whatever, to work towards, to accumulate something in my life. What we have always known to be human, right? Whether you're in your hunter-gatherer society, sorry, it's cold out here, my lips are freezing. Hunter-gatherer society or in civilized society of one advanced stage or another. There's always this need, this desire for the family unit to increase their wealth so that they can pass, so the next generation doesn't have it so difficult, right? And so they want to break that so you'll own nothing. And you'll be happy. Why would I be happy? And then when you see things like Metaverse being rolled out, this alternate VR you could just live in, right? Be hooked up to, like in the Matrix, you're hooked up to a machine all day and your body's wasting away, or they're harvesting its energy. You're stuck full of tubes. That's, what kind of existence is that, right? So that you'll be happy because you'll have happy chemicals swimming in your brain constantly, right? So it's, who wants to live into that? That's disgusting, in my point of view. So this is why the reason why Southern Time Productions and Southern Time Foundation especially Silent Time Productions, right? Silent Time Foundation will do its work, but it'll be funded primarily through Silent Time Productions and eventually through the public at large. They will see the verifiable good it's doing. And they'll fund it. But it's Silent Time Productions using the power of art, of finely tuned, crafted, and extremely entertaining music and film with a message, a socially conscious message, to raise people up. It won't be so obvious. It won't be a boring documentary. We'll have exciting documentaries, but our fiction will expand the mind. Like you see in movies, it's like, I never thought that great concept before, the big concept. Like every movie, every film we'll put out will do that. You know, so this to create something so grand takes resources, right? You know, what we've done so far, initial album of Southern Time Band, it was one good song, Searching for Love. The rest, you know, I want to redo them because the whole process was rushed. I didn't have bare minimum budget to pay the musicians. We didn't rehearse at all, just went in and recorded. You know, it was not a recording process that I wanted, so that's what you get the result. But if you have a budget where you can pay them, because they're professional musicians, pay them to rehearse until the band becomes a unit, you know exactly what to do, and then you have time to edit it, and it's not rushed like it was. So anyways, for us to make a difference in the world, we need funding ASAP. We need to start pre-production no later than March this year. All right. Hope you guys are doing good. This is going to be the first day of my campaign. I'm going to do this until I get it. This is the end of the Dreamer series too. How I do this now, every action I take will be documented in the montage at the end of the series, the last episode of the series. So, and it ends, well, there will be after, but the key point in the last episode is when I get that investment, that first investor. And it leads to more investments until we get what we need to. For the next, this should be the only seed funding we'll need, I think, until we go public, maybe in 3 or 4 years. So guys, take care. Talk to you tomorrow.